Hey there, sis, it's me again. So we're gonna continue on with iPhoto. This next little tutorial is gonna be on how to use the effects. So we'll just get right into it. So here we are in iPhoto again, but this time we're in editing, but in the effects tab. And once again, I have to point out that there really isn't much we can do with this picture of me because I just look so awesome anyway, especially with my Dallas Cowboy jersey. So, but anyway, I'll show you the different effects tools that are here. The first one here we have is Lighten. So I can click on Lighten and it's gonna lighten the picture just a little bit. And I can keep on clicking on it, you know, to lighten it up. And then Darken. As you may have guessed, we'll do the opposite. So it will darken the image. I click on it a few times and it'll get darker. Now with the contrast, I can make adjustments to the contrast and I can keep hitting it and you can see it's changing the contrast. Yeah, that's too crazy. And then I can do warmer. And these are all just presets. So I can hit warmer and I can just keep clicking on it and the picture will get warmer. Or I can click cooler and the picture will get cooler. It'll bring more blues. Warmer brings in more reds and cooler brings in more blues. And then saturate, I can just hitting saturate to oversaturate the picture if I want to. But then we have these kind of pre-built effects tools. And so we have black and white, so I can just change it to black and white if I want to. Or I can change it to sepia tone. I want to get that old fashioned look. And you remember those because I think this is what cameras look like when you were growing up. And then antique, you'll see it does some antiquing again, which you should probably know about because that's cameras were antiques or are antiques compared to your age, I guess. So, and then we have a matte, so you can add a matte to it. So like if you know some fancy edges or whatever, and feathering, and then a vignette. So I'm gonna turn off matte. So we got, there's different mattes. So I'm learning something new. So I can hit matte a bunch of times and it'll kind of zero in. But that's not good. So I will go back all the way back out to zero on this one. So there's no matte. And then vignette does kind of similar thing as matte, but it does the black piece. So I'm gonna turn that back to zero. Then edge blur. So it's gonna, I don't know if you can see this very well, but it kind of blurs out the edges. Now you see it's kind of blurring in. So it gives you kind of a nice little effect. Bring that back up to zero. And then fade. You can just kind of fade out the picture to black and white. And then we've got boost. So that's boosting all the color out of it. All right, just so it makes it really warm, I guess. And then I can hit none and it just reverts the picture back to before when I did all the lightening and darkening and stuff. So you still see the saturate, the oversaturate. But again, like I said before, you know, you're not destroying the picture. So feel free to explore and play with any of the images because you're not going to destroy anything because I can always click this revert to original and then bam, it's right back the way it was to my beautiful self. And that's a hopefully this one was helpful for you on learning the different effects. And in the next episode, we're going to talk about adjusting the various levels of the image itself.